Chapter 54. Of divination, and its kinds. There are some other kinds of divinations, depending upon natural causes, which are known to everyone in his art, and experience, to be in divers things, by which physicians, husbandmen, shepherds, mariners, and every one of these out of probable signs do prognosticate. Many of these kinds Aristotle made mention of in his Book of Times. Amongst which augurier and auspicia are the chiefest, which were in former time in such esteem amongst the Romans, that they would do nothing that did belong to private or public business without the counsel of the augurs. Cicero also in his Book of Divinations largely declares, that the people of Tusa would do nothing without this art. Now there are divers kinds of auspicias, for some are called pedestria, that is, which are taken from four-footed beasts, some are called auguria, which are taken from birds, some are celestial, which are taken from thunderings and lightnings, some are called caduca, that is, when any fell in the temple or elsewhere, some were sacred, which were taken from sacrifices. Some of these were called piacula and sad auspicia, as when a sacrifice escaped from the altar, or being smitten made a bellowing, or fell upon another part of his body than he should. To these is added exaguration, viz., when the rod fell out of the hand of the augur, with which it was the custom to view and take notice of the opicium. Michael Scotus makes mention of 12 kinds of augurias, viz., 6 on the right hand, the names of which he saith are Fernova, Fervitis, Confort, Imponentham, Sunnas Arnova, Sunnas Arvitis, and the other 6 on the left hand, the names of which are Confernova, Confervitis, Viarum, Hernam, Scasanova, and Scasarvitis. Then expounding their names, he saith, Fernova is an augurium, when thou goest out of thy house to do any business, and in going thou sayest a man, or bird going, or flying, so that either of them set himself before thee upon thy left hand, that is a good signification, in reference to thy business. Fervitis is an augurium, when thou shalt go out of thy house for to do any business, and in going thou findest or sayest a bird, or a man resting himself before thee on the left side of thee, that is an ill sign in reference to thy business. Viarum is an augurium, when a man or a bird in his journey, or flying passeth before thee, coming from the right side of thee, and bending toward the left, goeth out of thy sight, that is a good sign concerning thy business. Confernova is an augurium, when thou dost first find a man, or a bird going, or flying, and then he rest himself before thee on thy right side, thou seeing of it, that is a good sign concerning thy business. Confervitus is an augurium, when first thou findest, or sayest a man, or a bird bending from thy right side, it is an ill sign concerning thy business. Sunnas Arnova is an augurium, when a man, or a bird comes behind thee, and outgoeth thee, but before he comes at thee, he rests, thou seeing of him on thy right side, it is to thee a good sign. Sunnas Arvitis is an augurium, when thou sayest a man, or bird behind thee, but before he comes to thee he rests in that place, thou seeing of it, is a good sign. Confort is an augurium, when a man or bird in journeying, or flying shall pass behind thee, coming from the left side of thee, and bending toward thy right, pass out of thy sight, and is an evil sign concerning thy business. Scasarvitus is when thou sayest a man, or a bird passing by thee, and resting in a place on thy left side, it is an evil sign to thee. Scasnova is when thou sayest a man, or a bird passing by thee, and resting in a place on thy right side, is an augurium of good to thee. Imponentham is when a man, or a bird, coming from thy left side, and passing to thy right, goeth out of thy sight without resting, it is a good sign. Hartner is an augurium, if a man or a bird coming from thy right hand, passing behind thy back to thy left, and thou shall see him resting anywhere, this is an evil sign. Thus much Scotus. The ancients did also prognosticate from sneezings, of which Homer in the 17th book of his Odyssey makes mention, because they thought they proceeded from a sacred place, viz. The head, in which the intellect is vigorous and operative. Whence also whatsoever speech came into the breast, or mind of a man rising in the morning unawares, is said to be some presage, and an augurium.